In
Thanks.
Spring, we have different bean scope, right? By default, whenever we define our bean, it is singleton,
Correct.
right?
Yes.
Now, there are other bean scope as well, which we might not use frequently. That is prototype,
Yes.
session, global session,
Session fit, yeah.
etc. Right? My question is to you, can you explain me prototype bean with an example? When you will go with the prototype bean with an example, in which situation?
Yeah, prototype def means means when each time if you want to refresh the request, new sessions will be like new request ID will be generated. So that cases we can go for the prototype. Suppose if you have a customer email like a notification, so either that customer notification need to be update the orders. So right now what is that is in progress, completed or maybe failed or something. So the customer order notifications, we have to send this as a prototype, like that notifications request will be generated simultaneously. So that will be not fixed. So in that cases we can go for the prototype. While we are running e-commerce based application, in that we have order microservice. So in that order microservice or notification microservice need to be communicated. So while notification microservice will send the notification to the order, so that order's status will change. In that cases we can go for this request as a prototype from the notification service.
Okay, got that. Okay, so in Spring, basically, we define at the rate configuration annotation sometimes, right? Why? What is the need of at the rate configuration? When we define that, can you give me explain me with some example?
Yeah, so Spring Boot is a features which have taken at the rate a Spring Boot application like enable con auto configurations at the rate configuration and component scale. So if you are using single at the rate auto configurations or configurations means like a Spring Beans will be like a Spring automatically will create the configurations. Like suppose if you are doing any changes related for the messaging queue or any database database related changes if you want to add. So for that you need to add the driver in the pom.xml, and after that you have to add the driver dependency in pom.xml, and then you have to add the configurations which will be there in this application.yaml. So how this internally will call to communicate from while service layer, controller will call to sub service and service will communicate with the repository. So how this will be automatically will connect the database communications and take the request as per this user's password, driver name and all, and will perform the operation. So we have to create a data set. So data set class will be have a util class or maybe data connectors we can say if you are using Mongo or SQL. So SQL connectors will be there. So in that cases we have to do at the rate auto configurations or maybe configuration. So once you will do this configuration, so automatically the whatever the respective bins will be created, they have to check this respective application.yaml file, and according to that automatically will load this all the values.
Okay, got that. Okay, I can see you have worked on Kafka as well.
Yes.
Have you worked on ActiveMQs?
Active MQ I worked not much, but Kafka mostly I work. Some of the cases I use Active MQ.
Okay, can you tell me just so in Kafka architecture, there is a group of consumers, right? So, for example, you are publishing some messages, right?
Correct.
And there are from a provider, right? You are publishing a message on a topic, and this is a common topic, right? And there is a list of consumers who are actually consuming messages from that topic.
Correct.
I want, like, suppose there are 10 different consumers. Sorry, let's say five group of five consumers, right? Or same type. I just want that the only those same type, or suppose of type A, should consume that message. So what are the setting configuration we do? Can you tell me?
Yeah, so while we use a Kafka, so first we have to set up the Kafka and zookeepers will be there. And once you do the setups, then we have a three architecture of Kafka, which have a consumer, producer, and Kafka cluster. So Kafka cluster will work on this based monitoring to the zookeeper. So if we have two microservices, order microservice, notification microservice. So order microservice is a main microservice which will be communicated with all the microservice like checkout, cart, notification, payments and reports and all those things. So how they will do, like order microservice will generate the order detail and send it to the Kafka cluster. Kafka cluster will take, how he will take, based on the topic ID, either order has created, so this topic is order microservice. If checkout microservice is generating some request or maybe sending some response to the cluster or maybe order, then we'll have a checkout is a topic name. So based on the topic will be defined by the Kafka cluster. Oh, this is for the order microservice, this is for the checkout microservices. After that, notification service will get this. So how this will take? We have a in this con we have to write this application.yaml. There we have to create a Kafka cluster name, Kafka replications factors, and then whatever the key sets will be there, and the consumer, what is the consumer group. So suppose if you are generating the record, so for that we have order request. So that order request or maybe processing, so this type of consumers, they will create a like a consumer group for this particular order. According to that they have to process. So if you want a product, what you ask, like four five type of.
So I was asking like same type, like say suppose there is a common topic and you there you send the messages, right? But I want like that messages should be only emailed, right? So email consumer will come into picture, SMS consumer for example, and some other way, right? So how that will be
So
happening?
for that we need to create a consumer group based on the topic. We'll have a consumer group. So that consumer group, according to that, will be sent this request.
Let's say now I have another question. Suppose what happens like daily you are publishing or almost 1 lakh messages or 2 lakh messages. All your consumers are down. Consumer service is down for let's say another 2 3 days because of the production issue. Now your messages are getting piled up, right? And those messages which are already on your topic, those are not after 3 days. After 3 days, systems are restored, consumers are restored, but I don't want because now those messages are of no use, right? Because those were the live messages which customer was expecting to get, but because of our system failure, we cannot want to send those old messages to our customer. So what I should do? How you will solve this problem? How you will remove those messages, right? Because you have to clear those messages, right? How you will do that?
So while our consumer group or maybe will be off, in that cases Kafka cluster will have a retrieval. So they will try to retry. So by default retrieval, if you want, you can configure in this property.yaml file. So by default mostly we'll have a 3 times attempt. So if 3 times he will check if already this one is like has shut down or maybe not off, not working properly. In that cases they have to this message, we need to write like retrieval as a off, I think. Then
No, so suppose what happens like sometimes suppose your application daily sends email to the customers, right? Now since the consumers were down, so the messages start piling up, right? On the topic. Now your topic has messages from last 3 days, right? Which are not delivered to customers,
Customer, yeah.
right? Now what happens like fourth day the system is resolved, but I don't want those 3 day old data to my customer. I want to send the fresh ones, right? Which I will start publishing from the fourth day. Now for those 3 days, how I will remove those messages first? Because those are already piled up, right? Because see, if you send the new messages, so as per the FIFO, right? FIFO algorithm, Kafka will process the messages which has been received in the 3 days back, right? First they will process the old messages, then they will take the new messages, right? So but my problem is I don't want to process
Old
old
message.
3 days messages. I just want to process the fresh messages which we have just published on the Kafka topic. So how you do that? So is there any number concept in the Kafka? Do you know that?
That is there. Number concept, right? That I think
What is
in
that?
property.yml file, there only we have to do some configuration changes.
Do you know what is offset?
Yes, offsets, yeah.
What is that?
So that offsets, based on that only we will resolve this problem. Offsets, like we need to create a Offsets enabled as a true false.
No, no, that's not an issue. Offset I actually internally assigned, and that's fine. If you're not aware, that's not something we actually handle on a day-to-day basis. I'm just asking a general scenario that happens within production only. Okay. Coming to some question from microservices,
So
right?
what is the correct
So,
answer for this?
sorry, we will reset the offsets. We will start the offset from the for the new messages. So we will get to know. So if you whenever you check that topic, right, you will see the last offset, right? And you will reset to the offset. Suppose the last offset value is 10,000, right? So you will reset the offset value to 10,001. That is via command line. Okay, on that particular. So what it will do the next time, because it is like a pointer, right, for your Kafka cluster. So it will ignore all those 10,000 messages and will take consider only the messages from the 10,001. That is your new message. Okay,
Yeah,
so
understood.
that's how Kafka works actually. Okay, and or you can do one more thing. You can just write basically start a new thread of your consumer. And you will what you will do, you will ask that thread, boss, consume these messages from this offset number to suppose 1 to 10,000. So it will consume those all these messages. You just write, you can run your own command line Kafka consumer on that server. Okay, so it will all consume all the messages. Your Kafka cluster is or topic is empty now. Now you can publish the new messages. So there are two ways. That's how you can handle this problem. Okay, but this is a very rare problem that happens only in the production environments. Many times, you know, because people say the Kafka is very stable, but this how sometimes Kafka go for a toss, and these are the situation which actually happens only in the productions. When you have multiple messages on the day-to-day basis, if you don't have the backup of your Kafka cluster, then this kind of problem happens. Okay. So
Yeah, understand.
usually what happens, like in this case of scenario, if your cluster Kafka cluster goes down or your consumer group goes down, then another group comes into picture, your master slave mode, right? That's how things works in production. So if your master is down, your slave comes into picture, right? But the scenario which I was asking, this is so simply a standalone cluster. We doesn't have any backup. In that situation, we will have to hand manage by manually like this, either consuming those messages or reset your offsets, right?
Yeah, understand.
Okay. So I have one question from microservice architecture. So in microservice architecture, you know, right, there are multiple microservices we write.
Correct.
And for example, let's say you are a client and you are a client and you are sending a request. Now, what happens? Your request goes to your microservice one from the gateway. After passing the gateway, it will hit the microservice 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 till 10. Okay. And from there, the response will come. Now, sometimes what happens? There is some error, right? So suppose you send the request and it and the request broke somewhere in the microservice 8. Okay. Now, how you will get to know like where your request is actually broken? Because there are a lot of logs, right? So each microservice is writing his own logs on and so on the central system, right? How you will identify that your request, this is the particular request which is actually, you know, turned into a failure. So how you will actually detect that, like why this is the actual request which is went into error? How you will actually, I would say, debug that simply.
Correct. So first what we will do, first we have to do the centralized log by using a Splunk or ELK in
Right.
we because we have multiple microservices. So through that ELK or
Correct.
Splunk we can handle by the ID and all, so and by the microservices level also. And others we have a Spring Cloud component, so we need to use a Spring Cloud component of Hystrix circuit breaker. So that circuit breakers will be there in the all microservices service business logic, where suppose if any microservice is failing, so that we know like which microservice is failing. So how we will do, like each microservice will have a business logic implementation method. So in that method we have to enable the circuit breaker, so that circuit breaker will have a fallback method. So either fallback method, if microservice is down from 8th of microservices, in that cases they will send a request, they will send one response from this microservices, I'm not able to communicate from this 8th of microservices response, so please try after some time, or maybe our service is down due to some technical issues. So that e easily we can get this logs also, and through this circuit breakers dashboard there we can also check.
So, Amarjit, sorry, I would like to interrupt you here. So, I just want to know how you will track this request end to end.
Okay, so if I want to track this request end to end, then for each request, while if you are processing any request through the API, will generate this some spam ID and spam ID and one unique ID. So through that, we have to check the timestamp at what time this API has hit, and what is the exact unique ID is spam ID and one more ID is there. So through that, we have to check in this Splunk. So we'll get this all the timestamp and respective microservice communications.
Got that. Let me quickly jump to the next question. That is from Angular. Are you comfortable with Angular question?
Yeah, not much, but mostly backend and DevOps and AWS I work, but Angular also I prefer that.
No problem. Let me ask some question like in Angular, there is a concept of observables. Do you understand? Do you know what is that?
Observable in this design patterns you are asking, the design patterns.
No,
Okay.
not design
Okay.
patterns.
Yeah.
So basically, there is a concept of observables and promises in Angular. Do you know what is that?
Observable. I think not sure exactly.
Okay, no problem, no problem. Okay, let's not ask that question from that area. Okay, Amarjit, let's quickly jump on.